From Washington to Moscow, from New York to Paris, from Rome to Jerusalem, around the world, the prophecies of the Bible are being fulfilled. J.R. Church, author and lecturer, is standing by with today's analysis of Bible prophecy. History has reached an impasse. The world is soon to see the return of Jesus Christ. And now, here is J.R. Church with today's prophecy in the news.
In Matthew chapter 24, verse 3, the disciples took Jesus up to the Mount of Olives overlooking the city of Jerusalem and asked him privately, "Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?" In answer to their questions, Jesus gave the most incredible prophetic discourse ever to fall from the lips of a prophet. Jesus did not at all seem to try to evade their questions, but spent a considerable time to the answer. It would seem that on the surface, Jesus was trying to evade their initial question, when? For he said in verse 36, "But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only." From that answer, we must conclude one of three things. First of all, did Jesus, who was the omniscient Christ, the creator of all things and the author of the Bible, not really know when? Second, was he simply trying to evade the question so that the disciples, nor anyone else for that matter, would ever know? Or three, did he hide within the veiled language of this Olivet discourse the dates in answer to their question, when? Is it there, though we cannot see it, perhaps one day to be revealed? I want to talk with you about that possibility on today's prophecy in the news. I want us to explore the original Hebrew language spoken by Jesus on this occasion. And I want to show you not only the English translation of those words, but I want to show you the numerical values as they appear in the Hebrew language. There are some languages in the world that derive their numbers from the letters of their alphabets. Roman numerals, for instance, comes from the Latin alphabet. I equals 1, the letter V equals 5, the letter X equals 10, the letter L equals 50, the letter C equals 100, and the letter D equals 500. In similar fashion, the Greek and the Hebrew alphabets provided their numerical values. In the Greek language, the first letter, alpha, was equivalent to their number 1. Beta equaled 2, gamma equaled 3, delta equaled 4, and so on, down to the letter iota, which equaled 10. Then the next letter, kappa, equaled 20, and so on, down through to the number 100. Then the next letter, sigma, equaled 200, tau, 300, and so on, down to the last letter, omega, which equaled 800. Likewise, the Hebrew alphabet derived its numbers from its letters. The first 10 letters were equivalent to the numbers 1 through 10. And so, aleph equaled 1, beth equaled 2, gamel equaled 3, and so on, down to through 10, and then the next letter equal 20, then 30 and 40, and so on, down to 100, then 200, 300, and 400. In the Hebrew religion, there is a group of men known as the Kabbalists, or the Kabbalah. They are the Jewish mystics who study the ancient writings of the Talmud for its mystical value. Their commentary on the Talmud is called the Zohar. They can take a Hebrew word and turn it from a word into a number. Now, Sir Isaac Newton was a Jewish mystic. He predicted a number of things in addition to his brilliant discoveries and his theories on gravity and so on. Sir Isaac Newton wrote some fantastic predictions. But his writings were not accepted by the Jewish community because they were too Christian. And they were not accepted by the Christian community because they were too Jewish. Sir Isaac Newton, a Jewish mystic, said that one day a nation would befriend the Jewish people and bring them back into their homeland, and then in the following years would turn against the Jewish people. Well, Britain certainly fits in that role. But now that's an example of a Jewish mystic called a Kabbalist. They can take a Jewish letter, such as this one, and they can turn it into a number. They can add two little marks that look like quotation marks above the next to the last letter and turn that word into a number. They call those two little quotation marks Avi Ka Debar. Translated, it means, as my father would have said it. Avi, my father, Ka, as, and Debar would have said it. Avi Ka Debar. Over the years, that Jewish mystical word used by the Kabbalists has been transliterated to be Abri Ka Dabri, or Abra Ka Dabra. So let us take some key words from the Olivet Discourse, where Jesus gives the signs of the times concerning the destruction of Jerusalem, the sign of his second coming, and of the end of the world. In Luke chapter 21, verse 20, Luke's account of the Olivet Discourse has Jesus foretelling the destruction of Jerusalem. And when ye shall see Jerusalem compassed with armies, then know that the desolation thereof is nigh. Jerusalem and the desolation thereof. In the original language of the Hebrew, Jesus was actually saying the Gentile nations are going to destroy Jerusalem. They are going to leave it desolate. They will make a tell of Jerusalem. Now, a tell is a heap, an archaeological heap. The original Hebrew looks like this. Goyim to tell Yerushalayim. Now let us take the words Goyim to tell Yerushalayim and find its numerical value. First, we must use the sign of the Jewish Kabbalists, Avi Ka Debar. Now the word becomes a number. Aleph equals 3. Ta equals 400. Another ta equals 400, total 800. And a lamed equals 30. So here we have the number 3830, or 3830. Jesus said, Goyim to tell Yerushalayim, or the Gentile nations will make a tell, or archaeological heap of Jerusalem, 3830. Now let's suppose that Jesus was giving the disciples the date in the Jewish calendar for the destruction of Jerusalem. The year 3830 in the Jewish calendar translates into our Gregorian calendar the year 70 A.D. Could it be that Jesus was using mystical language, words that had numerical values, that actually corresponded to the date that event would take place, and thus was answering the question of the disciples, when shall these things be? In the Jewish calendar year of 3830, or 70 A.D., Titus and the Roman soldiers besieged the city of Jerusalem, destroyed the temple built by Herod, and crucified tens of thousands of Jews. According to Josephus Flavius, there were so many crosses in and around Jerusalem that there was found no more wood with which to make crosses. The Roman soldiers crucified as many as 4 people on 1 cross. The great Herod's temple was burned to the ground. The crown of gold that skirted the roof of the temple began to melt and ran down in the cracks between the stones. When the Roman soldiers discovered the gold, they tore apart every stone in an effort to retrieve the gold. Thus, the prophecy of Jesus was literally fulfilled. Not one stone was left upon another that was not thrown down. Goyim to tell Yerushalayim, Jesus said, the Gentile nations will make a destruction or tell of Jerusalem. 3830 in the Jewish calendar, 70 A.D. Goyim to tell Yerushalayim, Jesus said, the Gentile nations will make a destruction of Jerusalem. 3830 in the Jewish calendar, 70 A.D. Well, let's look a bit further. In Luke chapter 21, verse 25, Jesus said, and there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. Distress of nations, or the shaking of the nations. In Matthew, Jesus put it this way. He said, nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. He said, there shall be wars and rumors of wars. Distress of nations. In the original Hebrew, it looks like this. Ha terad ha goyim. Now let us find the numerical value of this Hebrew word for distress or shaking. He equals 5. Ta equals 400. Resh equals 200, or a total of 600. M equals 70. And Dalag represents 4, or 5, 6, 7, 4. Avi ka debri, as my father would have said it. Could it be that Jesus was using the numerical values of these phrases to answer the questions the disciples asked, when shall these things be? Was Jesus saying in the Hebrew calendar year 5674 there would be a shaking of the nations? Nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There shall be wars and rumors of wars. The year 5674, converted to our Gregorian calendar, equals the year 1914 and the beginning of World War I. For the first time in the history of the human race, the entire world was involved in war. Old boundaries were dissolved. New boundaries were laid. There was indeed a shaking of the nations. Say, was it a coincidence that the numerical value of the terminology used by Jesus just happened to be the exact date in the Jewish calendar when that event took place? The study at this point becomes rather intriguing. Let's look further into the Olivet Discourse to see if there is another special sign described by Jesus. In Matthew chapter 24, verse 9, Jesus said, then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you. And ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. At this point, Jesus begins to describe to his disciples a persecution that shall befall the Jewish people in the end time. The word kill in this verse is the same one used in the Ten Commandments, "Thou shalt not kill," or "Thou shalt not commit murder." And so here, Jesus talks about the murder. The original Hebrew word looks like this, ha terazah. At this point, Jesus begins to describe the great persecution that shall sweep over the Jewish people. They shall be squeezed together, he said. Our word for that today would be concentrate. And our thoughts go back to the concentration camps of Germany. They shall deliver you up, Jesus said, and to be afflicted, and shall kill you, or shall commit the murder. And our thoughts go back to the Holocaust, when 6 million Jews perished in the gas chambers of Hitler. Now let us do as the Jewish Kabbalists would do, and place our Avi Ka Debri above the word. The word Ha Terazah then becomes a number. The letter He equals 5. The letter Ta equals 400. The letter Resh equals 200, total 600. The letter Sadi equals 90. And the letter Het equals 8, or a numerical value of 5, 6, 9, 8. Is it possible that Jesus was describing the date of the Holocaust when he talked about the murder of the Jewish people, which was fulfilled in World War II? The number 5698 in the Jewish calendar, translated to our Gregorian calendar, comes to the incredible date 1939 and the beginning of the persecutions of the Jewish people in Germany that led to the execution of 6 million Jews. Are you beginning to get the picture? From the original terminology used by Jesus in the Olivet Discourse, wherein he gives the signs of the times concerning the end of the world, we have found the numerical values that correspond to the dates those prophecies were fulfilled. World War I, with its shaking of the nations, prepared the land for the people, prepared Palestine for the Jewish people. World War II, with the murder of 6 million Jews, prepared the people for the land. For you see, in World War I, the land was prepared for the people, but the people were not prepared for the land. But in World War II, the people were driven back home. Both events, Ha Terad Ha Goim and Ha Terazah, were very specific signs given by Jesus in the Olivet Discourse, and their numerical values, 5674 and the year 5698, happen to be the exact dates of the fulfillments of those prophecies. We have been looking at the fantastic original Hebrew wording of the Olivet Discourse given by Jesus in answer to the question of the disciples, when shall these things be? We have seen that Jesus said, Goyim to tell Yerushalayim, or Jerusalem, and the desolations thereof. When we use the technique of the Jewish Kabbalists, or the Jewish mystics, and put our abracadabra, or avi kadabri, above the word, tell Yerushalayim, we turn the word into a number, and that number comes to 3830. The year 3830 in the Hebrew calendar happens to be 70 A.D. And then we come to the word spoken by Jesus, Ha Terad Ha Goyim, where Jesus said, there shall be a shaking of the nations, or distress of nations. Now we've looked back to the original Hebrew word, added our Avi Kadabri, and change the word into a number, it comes to the Hebrew word 5674. That corresponds in our calendar to the year 1914. And then we studied the words used by Jesus, ha terazah, or translated, Jesus was saying, they shall deliver you up and shall kill you. He talks about the murder. Ha terazah, in the original Hebrew language, has a numerical value. When we place our avi kadabri up above the word, it translates then into the number 5698. The year 5698 translates to the year 1939 and the beginning of the murder or the Holocaust. We have seen now these fantastic signs. Let us now look at another specific sign. It is found in Matthew chapter 24 and verse 8. All these are the beginnings of sorrows. The beginnings of sorrows. The words here translated, the beginning of sorrows, comes from the Hebrew word which means the birth pangs of travail. In fact, the original Hebrew wording, ha te shiak, actually refers to the last birth pang in the birth of a child. It is translated in other places as travail. All these are as the birth pangs of travail. Listen to the Hebrew word, shiach. Can you hear the pain itself? A very demonstrative language. Here's what it looks like in the original Hebrew language. Ha, te, shiach. Birth pangs. Bible prophecy teaches the birth, or rather we should say, the rebirth of the nation of Israel. God, throughout the Bible, refers to Israel as my son. Now let us add avi kadabri to the word ha te sheok. This Hebrew word now becomes a number. He equals 5. Ta equals 400. Shin equals 300, total 700, and het equals 8. So the word translated sorrows or travail in the original Hebrew language has a numerical value of 5708. 5708. Is it possible then that the Lord Jesus Christ was talking about the rebirth of the nation of Israel? And could he have given in prophecy the exact date according to the Hebrew calendar that such an event would take place? The Hebrew calendar year 5708 translates into our Gregorian calendar as 1948. Incredible, isn't it? For that was the year of the rebirth of the nation of Israel. The disciples posed the question, when shall these things be? Could the numerical values of those four Hebrew statements be coincidence, or could they be a part of a meticulously woven design in the plan of God? Jerusalem and the desolations thereof, Goyim to tell Yerushalayim, 70 A.D. The shaking of the nations, Ha Terad Ha Goyim, 1914. The murder, Ha Terazah, 1939. And the birth pangs of travail, Ha Te Shiach, 1948. Again, may I pose this question? Is the Word of God verbally inspired? Or was it simply recorded in later years from the fading memories of those who heard him speak? Another question. How do we compare this incredible finding with Matthew 24:36, where the Lord said, "But at that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only." Note, please, Jesus said, "My Father knows." Since the Father knows, and since the prophecies were fulfilled on the exact dates of their Hebrew numerical values, then we must conclude that the authorship of the Bible and its verbal inspiration are divine. And now, the inevitable question. Are there other prophecies given by Jesus in the Olivet Discourse that bear incredible numerical values? That's a very good question.